Ladies and gentlemen, it's November the 4th, 2008, and I stand out in front of the National Center for Martin Luther King. Down just a few feet away from me, you hear the crowd chanting, "Yes, we can," in support of Barack Obama. The time is getting very short to start hearing the words and to the count of all of the states throughout the United States. Very exciting night. Let's find out what is happening here in Atlanta, Georgia, for Barack Obama.
Of justice and peace.
There is a God, there is a God, there is a God who rules the world in a heart of mercy and a heart of love, and if we let God fight our battles, we will be free someday.
I'll sing a song. The presence of the Lord is here. I'm telling you, the atmosphere, the atmosphere. The
All you had to do was get your soda pop and your sandwich and wait your turn. But one man took beatings for us and sticks for us, was thrown to the ground and stomped for us. And the reason we can go to the White House is he went to the Edmund Pettus Bridge. I'm glad that history has us watch tonight, that he lived to see the day that we're on our way to the promised land. Congressman John Lewis.
At the request of a friend, Senator Kennedy, at that time who was running for the President of the United States, ended up intervening and made a call to somebody. And our father was released from that prison. Our grandfather, Daddy King, Aunt Christine's father and my father's father, had it publicly endorsed Richard Nixon for president and decided that he was going to switch his vote and said if he had a suitcase full of votes, he would deliver them all to John F. Kennedy. This was about a couple of weeks before the election. That we must understand why we celebrate today. Tomorrow, and actually January 20th, or after the inaugural, we gotta roll up our sleeves so that the next president of the United States of America will become the greatest president of all times.
Martin Luther King Jr., he must be looking down from heaven saying, "Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah." He told us in Memphis that he has seen the promised land, that he may not get there with us, but as a people, we will get there. This election is not the promised land, but I tell you, it is a major down payment on the promised land. So I come representing a generation that says thank you. On a night that an African American is going into the White House, I want to thank those who have sacrificed, those that never hear us say thank you, but we are really deeply appreciative to that, knowing that we wouldn't have Jack if it wasn't for those who have come before us. So God bless you. We have already done it, so let's keep moving. God bless you.
We must now do our part. We must do our part, my dear brothers, by dropping your guns and picking up your books. We, my dear brothers, need you to leave the jails of America and join the movement for justice and equality. We need soldiers.
A.D. King, Martin Luther King Jr. And I'm thinking about that night in Memphis when he gave that great, and I guess it was a farewell speech, when he said, I may not get there with you, but we as a people will get to the promised land.
I would say to the youth, prepare yourself, continue so that you can become a leader and help to bring about peace and justice for all mankind.
Dr. Whatnot, who is the pastor of the historical Ebenezer Baptist Church, it has just been announced that Barack Obama is the president-elect who has won the 2008 presidential election. As you can see, the crowd is in an uproar. Many people are in tears. It is an historic moment that many thought that they would never see in their lifetime. So it is a beautiful moment for African Americans. It is a beautiful moment for American history. We finally have our first African American president who has broke through the racial barrier, and America today has proved their worth by electing the best man for the job. We say God bless.
Just a collection of individuals for a collection of red states and blue states. We are and always will be the United States of America.
We got one of our famous videographers and photographers of Atlanta here for this historic
Obama!
Occasion. Lloyd Caldwell Jr. is in the house. Say some words about this historic event.
Oh, man, it's exciting, man. Everybody just in the place, man. It's a lot of energy. You can just feel it, man. It's just the greatest thing. Obama, President of the United States. How about that?
Judge Mathis, and I'm hanging out with Hit TV. Y'all keep doing the right thing. Keep waking us up.